Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the logical operators of JavaScript. In this video, I'm going to discuss the NOT operator, followed by the AND operator, together with the OR operator. For the AND operator, I would like to discuss the multiple AND operations. And for the OR operator, I'm also going to talk about the multiple OR operations. Finally, I'm going to talk about the precedence of the logical operators. Basically, it is in this order. NOT is more important than AND, and AND is even more important than OR. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is pretty simple. It just contains a title and a heading, and they are already shown on the right-hand side of the screen. And I'm going to link this HTML file to the JavaScript file that I'm going to handle for the time being. And the JavaScript file is stored inside the folder called JS, and the file name is simply myscript.js. And this folder is already at the same level of the HTML file. Okay, so I'm going to talk about the JavaScript file now. Before I want to run the JavaScript file, I have to make sure that I'm using the strict mode. In order to use the strict mode, I have to say use strict at the very beginning of the JavaScript file, which is this line, okay? Now I'm going to talk about the NOT operator first. The NOT operator can be represented by an exclamation mark. And it just means that we want to negate the Boolean variable that I'm going to apply the exclamation mark. So let us see an example. Suppose I have a variable called truth value, and the content is simply true, which is a Boolean value. If I want to set the negation of this truth value, what will I get? I will simply get false, because the exclamation mark is simply to the negation of the value contained in a certain Boolean variable. So let me try to save it and reload the page. Save, reload. You see, false is given out. So the answer is simply false according to the negation operator. So that is the basic idea of the negation operator. And I'm going to show you more examples about the negation in other cases. How about this one? If I want to do the negation of 1, it is quite sensible for us to get the result as false, because 1 can be regarded as the Boolean true value. So let us see the result. Save, reload. You see, false is given out because I'm going to do the negation of the true value represented by number 1. And in this situation, we simply do the conversion of number 1 to the Boolean true value before we do the negation, okay? And another example is something like this one. If I do the negation of null, what will I get? I will simply get true, because null can be converted to the Boolean false value. And in this case, when I do the negation of a false value, I will simply get true. So let me save the file and reload the page. Yes, true is given out because I'm doing the negation of false, okay? And we're going to see another example. How about this one? If I want to do the negation of undefined, what will I get? I will simply get true, actually, because I'm doing the conversion from the undefined value to the Boolean false. So let me see the result. Save, reload. Yes, true is given out, because I'm just doing the conversion to Boolean false before I apply the exclamation mark, which represents the negation. Okay? That Then I'm going to talk about the AND operator, which is represented by two ampersand joined together. For this operator to function well, we have to apply two conditions, and we have to make sure that both conditions are true in order to return true from the AND operator. So let us see an example. So I assign 2 to A and 8 to B. So what will I get when I want to check the Boolean value of A smaller than 3 and B larger than 6? I will get true actually, because 2 is simply smaller than 3 and 8 is simply larger than 6. So when these two conditions are both true, I'm going to get true according to the AND operator principle. So let us see the result by saving it first. Save, and then I reload the page. Yes, I will get true because the two conditions separated by the AND operator are both true. And now I'm going to talk about the multiple AND operators. So we can join so many AND operators together in one statement. So let us see an example of this case. For this one, we have 0 and 1 and true. So for this situation, we apply the multiple AND principle. We have to make sure that the idea is true for now. When we have multiple AND operators joined together, we have to return the first 4C result or the last result. So in this case, we can check the situation. 0 is regarded as the first 4C result. And 1 is of course a truthy result, and true is obviously a truthy result. So this one is a falsy result, and it is also the first falsy result in this expression. So we can expect that the alert window gives me false or is equivalent. So let us see the result. Save. Let me comment out this line first. Save. Reload. Yes, I will see 0 from the alert window. The idea is like this one. Zero comes out because it is simply the first value that is a false result, and zero is simply regarded as false in logical operation. When we have 0, we can convert it to false. Okay, so that is the reason why we have the result of 0 coming out, due to the first 4C value of the expression, okay? And let us see another example of multiple AND joined together. How about this one? So for this one, we have 7 AND high and true. We see that 7 is regarded as a truthy value because it is not 0 or undefined and so on. High is simply a long empty string and it can be converted to Boolean true. And true is of course regarded as a Boolean true value. So when all these truthy values are joined together, we simply return the last value. Okay, so I'm going to get true as the result. So let me see the effect by saving the page first. Save, reload. I will get true actually. The true value simply comes from the last value, which is this one. Okay, this is the effect of the multiple AND operators. And since the first and the second expressions are truthy values, the last one will be returned. So I will get true, which is the final expression. Okay, the next topic is about the OR operator. The OR operator can be simply expressed by two vertical lines or two pipes. And the condition for the OR operator to return true is that at least one of the conditions is true. Okay, so let us see an example. Suppose C is equal to 9 and D is equal to 4. How can we compare these two values? Let us see an example. How about this one? C is actually larger than 5 because C is equal to 9. And D is also smaller than 8 because D is equal to 4. So in this situation, both conditions are true. In this case, we can return true from this expression. Okay. So let me save it and run it. Save, reload. Let me see. I have to change it to comma. Let me save it and run it. Okay, I'll get true because both expressions are true. And when these two true expressions are joined together by the OR operator, we will get true because now we have more than one condition being true. And we are going to talk about the multiple OR operators. The idea is like this. The first true D value or the last result is returned. So that is an example of the multiple OR operations. Suppose we have this expression, empty string, OR false, OR hello. What will we get? We will get hello, actually, because this empty string is regarded as a falsy value, and false is of course a falsy value. And in this case, I will simply return the last result, or the first truthy value. So hello is a non-empty string. It is simply regarded as the truthy value, which is also the first truthy value in this long expression. And it is also the last expression that gives me the last result of the entire expression. Okay. And hello is also regarded as the last result of the entire expression. So for this situation, we have to return hello as the answer. So let me see the result. Save, reload. Yes, hello is coming out. So we can say that hello is the last value that has to be returned because the first and the second values are falsy. And how about another example? Let us see the effect for this particular expression. Okay, for this situation, I have another idea like this one. 0 is regarded as a falsy value, and 8 is regarded as the first truthy value of this entire expression. So we will expect that 8 will be given out, because 8 is simply the first truthy value, okay? And in this case, we don't need to bother with the third part of the entire expression because we have been able to determine the answer already according to the first two little expressions. So let me save it. Sorry. Let me save and reload. Yes, I will get 8, which is simply the first truthy value of the entire expression. Finally, I'm going to talk about the precedence issue. The NOT operator is having a higher ranking than the AND operator, which is having a higher ranking than the OR operator. So what does it mean by this kind of operator precedence? In order to understand this preference order, we have an example that illustrates it. So let me try to type the expression first. Okay, for this one, we will have a certain comparison before I can determine the final answer. Okay, when we see the operator precedence, we will see that AND comes first. So we have to handle this expression and this expression. And after handling these two expressions, I'm going to handle the OR operation. So true and false is simply handled first, which gives me false, and true and true is handled later, so it will simply give me true. So false, true are operated by the OR operator. Okay, so false or true here, I will get true instead. So the idea is summarized here. The first part is true and false, which is handled first, and then I'm going to handle true and true. And this part gives me false, and that part gives me true. When I go to the OR operator, I will have true. So let me save it and run it. See, true is coming out. So the idea is like this. Even though I don't have the parentheses that enclose the first part and the second part, I will still have true being the answer because it is already implied that the AND operators will be executed first. After that, I will handle the OR operator. So the parentheses that surround true and false or true and true are unnecessary in this case. Okay, let us see another example of the operator precedence. Now, since the OR operator is surrounded by a pair of parentheses, we have to handle this part first. After handling this part, I'm going to get the result of the expression shown here, and I'm going to make the comparison with false, which is using the AND operator. So I will handle this part first, which gives me true, and we are going to handle the comparison designated by the AND operator. So true and false will simply give me false. So let me see the result. Save. Reload. Yes, false is coming out because this part is true and this part is false. True and false gives me false. So this is the operator precedence. So in order to execute the OR operator first, you have to add a pair of parentheses to surround the expression that includes OR operator. Okay. Finally, I have another example. Okay, how about this one? Negation false means that we have to handle this part first because we can see that the NOT operator has a higher precedence than the AND operator. So this part simply gives me true. So true or true simply gives me true. So this is true, and true or true gives me true. Okay, so then let me save it and reload the page. Yes, I will get true because this is the result of the operator precedence. I don't do the OR operation first, so I don't do true or false followed by the NOT operator. So I have to handle this part first followed by the OR operation. Okay, so this is the operator precedence issue. We have to make sure that NOT is more important than AND, which is more important than all. Okay, so this is the major idea of the operator precedence issue of JavaScript. So this video has already talked about so many things about logical operators. The first thing is that the NOT operator is introduced, followed by the AND operator. And I've also handled the cases for multiple AND operators joined together. I also talked about the OR operator together with the multiple OR operations joined together. Finally, I've talked about the precedence issue of the NOT, AND, and OR operators. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.